Recently, I got a question from a viewer of the channel about recommendations for RSS feed readers. And this is a tough one because I have used RSS feed readers in my 12 or 13 year history of using desktop Linux, but I've never used anything that was a traditional RSS feed reader. For example, in my early days of using Linux on the desktop, I was using a terminal-based RSS feed reader called Canto. Canto is no longer being developed. There was another great terminal-based RSS feed reader called, I think, NewsButer or something like that, that was pretty popular way back then. And here recently, in the last few years, there's a great terminal RSS feed reader called NewsBoat that I've used in the past. I think I made a video about NewsBoat a couple of years ago. I've used NewsBoat on and off for the last few years as well. And of course, here recently, what I've been doing for a feed reader is just using Emacs, because let me open up Emacs. Emacs has a great RSS feed reader called LFeed. It's an extension. You need to install it, of course. But once you install LFeed, you know, it's just your standard RSS feed reader. I could go down here and read this story here. And, you know, if I wanted to, I could go down to the link here for the full story. Let me W a couple of times to get over to the link, and then hit enter, and it's going to open up the full story in the Emacs web browser. Emacs is built-in web browser here, and you know, it just opens it in a split, and I could read the story or whatever, cue to quit out of the EWW web browser, and cue to get back into the main frame of LFeed here. This video is not about LFeed, though, inside Emacs. And that's the thing, is I know most, especially people that ask a question like, hey, can you recommend an RSS feed reader? They're probably new to Linux. They're not sure what's available for an RSS feed reader in Linux. And I can't tell those people to go install Emacs and then go install LFeed, because they're not going to know anything about Emacs, and they probably don't even want to install Emacs. I'm also not going to point them in the direction of NewsBoat unless they specifically ask me, hey, I need a terminal-based RSS feed reader. No, most people want a GUI application. And there are some good ones. Even though I've never used them long-term, I often check them out, especially when I do distro reviews and things, and there is a great RSS feed reader that I came across a couple of years ago that really impressed me, and I wanted to share that with you today. So that graphical RSS feed reader that really impressed me a couple of years back was one called FeedReader. Now, there is a problem with FeedReader, and why I'm actually not going to discuss FeedReader today is because it's no longer being maintained. If I go to the GitHub repository for FeedReader, you can see this repository has been archived by the owner. It is now read-only and hasn't seen a commit in about 2 years. And if you read further, you can see that the guy that created FeedReader and was maintaining it, he quit maintaining FeedReader to go create a new RSS feed reader called NewsFlash. NewsFlash, the source for that, is hosted over on GitLab instead of GitHub, and it looks exactly like FeedReader. I mean, it's almost an exact clone. Why did he go and create a new RSS feed reader? I think it had something to do with the language. It looks like FeedReader was written in Vala and C for the most part, and NewsFlash, the current version of this program, is actually written in Rust. And of course, Rust is the new hotness, so I know a lot of you guys are looking for Rust programs to try out. For those of you that want to install NewsFlash, NewsFlash is available as a flat pack. That's probably the easiest way to get it installed on most distros. You could compile it, but the owner does recommend that you don't actually try to compile it from source. He just recommends everybody just to use the flat pack. For those of you on Arch-based systems, NewsFlash is available in the AUR. Since I'm on an Arch-based distro, I went ahead and installed NewsFlash from the AUR. And if I go over to my desktop, let's go ahead and launch NewsFlash. So let me go ahead and launch it for the very first time. When you launch NewsFlash, it's going to ask you about RSS services. So if you do your RSS feeds through syncing with an online RSS service such as Miniflux, Fever, Feedly, or Feedbin, you can actually use those services. Now, I don't belong to any of those services, so what I'm going to choose is local RSS. So I'm just going to maintain my RSS feeds locally here, and the very first time you run it, it's going to ask you about featured topics. Some of the stuff I really am interested in, of course, is open source, so I'll click on that. And if I want to, well, it's already going to give me some results here, some feeds I could subscribe to. I want open source for you. We could go ahead and add that feed. We have to set a title. The title is already filled in for us. Of course, you could edit it, and then you need to set a category. I think for a category, I'm just going to do open source for the category title. And click add, and then open source security. I don't know what that is, but now open source is available for the category for us to choose. I'll do the open source initiative blog. We'll also put that under the open source category. Open source collaborative network, another one I've never heard of, but I'll subscribe to it. Let me see if I can go back and do a different category. So instead of open source, I could search for, how about Linux? Ah, great. Linux Journal. Linux Journal, I believe, is still being maintained. Let's do a different category, though. I'll create a specific Linux category. Linux Today, I will also add. And I won't bore you guys, when you're subscribing to a million things. I'll subscribe to Reddit. Is this r/Linux? Probably is. And now that we've got a few things added, let me see how we get this thing to refresh. It looks like there's an icon right here. Yeah, let's go ahead and hit that. And you have this three column layout where you have your categories. And then, of course, for the categories, you'll, of course, get your RSS feeds here. And then if you click it, it will actually give you the full story, it looks like, which is really nice. Let me go to the Linux category, the Linux Journal. Does it give me the full story? I know the Linux Journal stories are typically very long. Yeah, it will give you the entire story when you click on the news feed itself, the RSS feed here. So I will say, you know, for those of us that are used to using things like terminal RSS feed readers like NewsBoat or LFeed inside Emacs, this is a little bit easier to work with because in NewsBoat, you've got to view the story in some way. You're probably going to have to view the story if you want to view the full story in a terminal-based web browser like Lynx. Of course, in LFeed and Emacs, when you want to view the full story, you've got to use a Emacs-based browser such as EWW. You don't have to do any of that in a GUI program like Newsflash. You know, you just click on it and you'll go ahead and get the full story. It even includes the images and everything from the story. So really, really nice. One of the things that is annoying me right now, though, is theming, because I have... I'm not sure what GTK theme I have set here in Arco Linux. It looks like one of the Arc themes, you know, which is kind of a dark bluish black color. But this column over here is not respecting the GTK theme. So what I want to do is I want to fix that, and it is fixable. What you need to do is go to the little hamburger menu here and go to settings. And in settings, go to dark mode. If I turn that on, we get a dark mode, which does now turn the white articles, you know, that were before black text on a white background. It flips those, but it also gives this column a black background as well. You know, it's white font on black background as well. I'm going to turn that off. I actually just want this to respect the GTK theme, if possible. If I go down here to article view, we could change, you could change the colors for the articles. Let me move that out of the way. Midnight is the name of that theme. It really looks like solarized. There's a Grubbox theme. I'm going to go with the default theme for now. You can also change the fonts. You can tick off the system font and then specify whatever font it is that you want to use. For me, I'm just going to go ahead and use the standard system font for this. It looks pretty good to me. Yeah, I was hoping I could change that column to respect the GTK theme, but it looks like the best I can do is just go to dark mode, which, honestly, I probably would want to use dark mode anyway. We do have key bindings also available for the settings. You know, you can go to next article, previous article with J and K, you know, the up and down keys for the Vim key bindings. I kind of like that. I actually had not tried that. So if I go J for down, yep, and K for up, yeah, very, very cool. I do like programs that respect the Vim motion keys. And really, that's mostly everything you need to know about Newsflash. Everything you want in a feed reader, everything you expect to be here, is here. I mean, you can mark things as red. So you get the circle up here, toggle as red. You also have toggle as starred, so you can star something if you want. And many people, of course, use tags with their RSS feeds, and you can add a tag with the tag symbol here. Click on it. This article has not been tagged yet. I could click add a tag. Of course, it tells me I need to create some tags first. Adding new tags, new categories, and new feeds inside Newsflash is very easy. Go to the first column here, and at the very bottom of the first column, you have plus and minus. Click the plus sign, and you have add, feed, category, or tag. And then you just click on whatever it is you're trying to add. For example, if there's a specific feed you want to add, just paste the URL to that feed right there. Now, one of the things that's really neat is, you know, not every feed you want to add is something that you've already know about, right? Sometimes you want to discover new feeds. And how do you discover new feeds? Well, you need to bring up that tool that we saw when we first launched Newsflash for the very first time. Go to settings and go to discover feeds, and you get that search box that we had at the very beginning, and that allows you to search for new feeds. For example, maybe I'm a hardcore gamer and I want to search for feeds related to gaming. And it gives me search results that I could add, such as Ars Technica Gaming or Gaming on Linux. That would be a good one to add. Gaming on Linux is a really fantastic publication. So that's just a very cursory look at Newsflash, which, again, is a graphical RSS feed reader. It's written in Rust, and it's available on every Linux distribution as long as you can run Flatpaks on that Linux distribution. It's also available, of course, in the AUR for those of you that run Arch or Arch-based distros. Now, before I go, I need to thank a few special people. I need to thank Abzi, Dallas, Devin, Fran, Gabe, Corbinian, Mitchell, Akami, Arch5530, Chris, Chuck, David, the other David, Donnie, Dylan, Gregory, Lewis, Paul, PickVM, Scott, Wes, and Willie. They are the producers of this episode. Without these guys, this quick look at the Newsflash RSS reader, it wouldn't have been possible. The show is also brought to you by each and every one of these ladies and gentlemen as well. These are all my supporters over on Patreon, because the DistroTube channel is sponsored by you guys, the community. If you'd like to support my work, look for DT over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace. I need to add 4chan to my feed reader.